So you want to make a dark fusion core reactor in HBM's mod? Welcome back to the channel, and in this video I'll be showing you how to build a dark fusion core reactor in HBM's nuclear tech mod. Let's get started. So the list of items that you'll need is on screen right now. So let's start building. If you're in creative mode, you can use infinite batteries and infinite fluid barrels, just so that you are aware. So the first thing, let's just place down our barrels and then our scaffold. There's no particular order in which you have to do these steps, just get them all done. As always, a link for the template will be in the description. So these two, they don't really matter. However, the emitter and receiver, is it receiver? Yeah. The emitter and receiver must be opposite each other. That is crucial. So once you've got this basic setup, we're going to place our dark fusion core in the middle, like this. So let me just organize my inventory a little bit. So let's start putting our things in the dark fusion core. So you're going to need a rubidium reaction catalyst. You're actually going to need two of them. You're going to need vibrant singularity in the center and another one of these in there. So the next thing we're going to do is start placing down fluid ducts, I think. Is probably the next thing we're going to do, is the next thing at least I'm going to do. Remember, no particular order to this, just as long as you get everything done, it will work. So this needs to be cryogel, and they all need to be set to output. This one also is cryogel. And remember, if you're in creative mode, you can use infinite barrels like I am here. And then this one, tritium, and then this one can be deuterium. And remember to set your pipes to the right thing, because otherwise you're going to have nothing inside of your dark fusion core. So once we've done all that, we'll eventually see from this one here, when I say this one, I mean the one, I mean this one, if we set it upright, we'll eventually, wait, oh, did I not put any, oh, that explains it, my bad. We'll eventually, now that I've done that, there we go, we'll see a beam go towards the dark fusion core, and if we open the dark fusion core, we can see tritium and deuterium are in there. So the next thing we are going to do is start putting some cables down. My instructions. That goes there, one there. So here we're going to place our spark energy storage block. It doesn't have to be a spark energy storage block. I think the minimum is probably the strobidium one is probably the lowest you'll want to go though. So we're going to put a power switch there, just needed to, just going to make sure that's clear. Just going to get everything. So next we're going to need our stabilizer lens. And we're going to put that in here and set this to 100. And make sure this is set to output as well. And now we're going to see a beam go into the dark fusion core from this one. And we'll, if you're inside, we see it's got a 100% restriction field, which is very important. Otherwise, there's not going to be much left of this place if there's no restriction field. So let's finally set up the receiver. We're going to there we go. Now let's get our FENSU and place that down there and just make sure that that's connected. I'm just making sure it's connected because otherwise you're going to be losing out on all that power. So that's all set up. Make sure it's on input mode, which it is on default. And we should be ready to turn this thing on. I'm just going to check. So yeah, see, always check because this, we needed to set it to 100 and click save. Remember to click save, otherwise it's not going to save. Once we check this is okay, we've checked that all this is okay. We've checked that everything has cryogel in it. We can turn this on because if you're in the radius where you can actually reach this, you're going to get burnt alive in survival. And then we're going to use this switch to turn it on. Now we have made a dark fusion core in HBM's nuclear tech mod. And you can see we are making a tremendous amount of power. So that is enough, about power producing through this is the same as filling one of these and slightly more every single second. And compared to the amount it consumes, yeah, it consumes a lot, 3 GHz a second, approximately. It's still, that's almost 1,000, no, it's probably not 1,000 times. I don't know off the top of my head how much many more times power is. I might put it in the edit, but yeah, it's a lot of power. You're creating more energy than you're using. So yeah, that'll be it for this video and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye.